Today we are going to start further Yes, let us start with the chapter Footprints Without Feet. The day before yesterday we have read about Griffin, who was a scientist who has invented certain rare drugs, and by swallowing those rare drugs one can become invisible. He has invented that formula, but Griffin was not at all the hero of the story. He is actually a villain. Why? Because he was adventurous in nature also. Moreover, he was notorious. He was committing various crimes, theft, robbery, and all that, right? As I told you that this is just an excerpt from the novel Invisible Man. So if you will read that complete novel, you will come to know that that Griffin, who is an intelligent scientist, and ultimately he has come out to be a villain at the end, and he is killed by the policeman because the police is always looking for him. He is always evading the police or evading the arrest, right? So what we have read here, that how he has set his house to fire, why he has set his house to fire, because of the reason he disliked his owner. And after that, what has happened? He has gone into the streets of London, where two young boys, they have discovered his footprints. And why those two boys were surprised? The two boys were surprised as no man was there, and they were surprised or they were amazed to see that the footprints were being visible and they are being produced from nowhere. Later on, these footprints, they escape because he has entered into a shop. So where he has entered into a store, departmental store, big store, where in order to protect himself from the extreme cold that was prevalent during that time. So what has happened? He has gone inside the store. He has his some purchased lunch. He has eaten various kinds of food, dishes. And after that, he had coffee, some wine also, and some sweets also. And later on, he has taken rest over a pile of pills. He wanted to have a safe sleep there. But ultimately, what happened in the morning, it was his bad luck that the boys or the storekeeper boys, they have arrived before he could wake up. And ultimately, Dilpreet, silence. And ultimately what has happened, that he has to take off his clothes and to go away, to run away from that place. And now after that, the next another thing is that the another problem in front of Griffin was that how he has to take care of the hollow space of his face, because he is completely invisible. He is as transparent as you can say glass, but as solid as glass too. Okay, one can touch, one can feel the presence of a body there, right? So he wanted to, because he has covered his head with hat. Now for the clothes that he was wearing, it was perfect, body is covered. But what he has to do about the hollow space behind or under the hat? For this, he has to go to a theatrical company shop, and then he has entered to Drury Lane, okay? So from here, we are going to start. Just open up. Page number is 28. For the offline ones, online ones, it is being displayed on your screen. So this time he decided to try the stock of a theatrical company in the hope of finding not only clothes, but also something that would hide the empty space above his shoulders. So what he thought, that now what he has decided, he decided to go to a theatrical company. Why? Because there he not only want to find some clothes for himself, but also he wanted to hide the empty space below his hat and above his shoulders. Shivering with the clothes, turn your face properly. Shivering with cold, he hurried to Drury Lane, the center of the theater world. So in the theater world, which is the main place, which is the main market there. It is in Drury Lane. Okay. So he soon found a suitable shop. There he was looking for shops. Then he came to a suitable shop where he thought that I could get all the things that I want. He made his way invisible upstairs and came out a little later wearing bandages round his forehead, dark glasses and false nose, big bushy side whiskers and a large hat. So he has went inside. He was choosing the things and ultimately he has come out how? He was wearing bandages around his forehead so that the forehead can't be visible. Then thick glasses covering his eyes, that is covering from this portion to this one. Now nose is left. He has put a false nose. Only that false nose was visible. Then for this upper lip, he has covered it with big bushy whiskers. Okay, mustache whiskers. And a large hat in order to cover his head because here the bandages are there. Then no head is visible, so he has covered it with his hat. To escape without being seen, he carelessly means roughly attacked the shopkeeper from behind, after which he robbed him all the money he could find. So see his notorious nature, what he has done. After taking all the things, what he has done, he has hit the shopkeeper from behind with a slap. And then afterwards he ran from there. And before that, what he has done? Oh, he stole all the money that was kept in the shop. He robbed the shop. So this means this was not a good quality of an intelligent man. Right. So next, eager to get away from crowded London, he took a train to the village of Iping. So now the next thing that was in his mind was that he should go from that where he should go from this crowded place, because there one problem is there to escape or to avoid this kind of crowd, because among number of people he has to take care where he should go, and people are also looking for his footprints. So this word also spread there. After the boys, they have found that invisible footprints of an invisible man. He wanted to go to Iping. Why? It is a far off place. Moreover, not many people have gone there. He would not find number of people there. So he booked two rooms at the local inn. So he has gone to Iping, where in an inn, inn means it is a place like that of an hotel, where you can take rooms on rent. So he has taken two rooms in the hotel inn. Why two rooms? One for himself and one for all the things that arrived with him. It was all his experimental material, test tube, number of boxes and all that. He has taken two rooms for rent there. The arrival of a stranger at an inn in winter was in any case an unusual event. So it was the slack time of the year. Slack time of the year means when not much trade or business is going on. Visitors are not often coming. So at that time, if in an inn, you can say the visitor is coming. So that was the most welcome thing. Okay. Yes, Prapreet. Where he has gone? Griffin, where he has gone now? Okay, sit down. So, a stranger of such uncommon appearance set all tongues wagging means moving. So when he has arrived at the inn, all of the people at the inn, they were talking about his strange appearance, because they have never seen such a man whose forehead was covered with bandages, wearing a false nose and completely covered with clothes. How is this possible? Mrs. Halls, the landlord's wife. So who was the owner of the inn? Mr. Hall. And his wife, Mrs. Hall. Mrs. Hall made every effort to be friendly. She tried all the ways to be friendly with Griffin. But Griffin is a scientist or is a person who never want to talk to anybody. There he has come to live a secluded life. because he is not talkative in nature. He doesn't like to talk to people. But Griffin had no desire to talk and told her, "My reason for coming to Iping is a desire for solitude. I do not wish to be disturbed in my work." Yes? Just a moment, please. "Besides, an accident has affected my face." So what he said, "My reason for coming to Iping is a desire for solitude." So when Mrs. Hall, she is extending some more conversations in order to be friendly with Griffin, he simply denied and he has simply made it clear, "Look, why I have come to Iping, it is just because of solitude. I wanted to live a solitary life. I don't want to talk to anybody. And moreover," he said, "I'd never like that anyone could come and disturb my work. I want to do my work in solitude." And he has told that an accident has affected my face. This is the reason why my face is covered with bandages. Now, satisfied that her guest was an eccentric scientist. Eccentric means not of normal nature. So Mrs. Hall, by this time, Mrs. Hall, she has come to know that this is not a normal man, something of abnormal nature. She understood that. And in view of the fact that he had paid her in advance, Mrs. Hall was prepared to excuse his strange habits and irritable temper. So Mrs. Hall, who was concerned only with money, she is satisfied with this thing that finally he has given me the money in advance so I can tolerate his irritable nature also. Moreover, if he wanted to live alone, that I won't disturb him. Okay, next. Tell him to sit properly. Then, I do not wish to be, But the stolen money did not last long, and presently Griffin had to admit that he had no more ready cash. So now, for how long that stolen money would run? Finally, he was short of money because he has given much money in advance. And now he has to make it clear to Mrs. Halls, "Now I have given you money in advance, but for the time being, I don't have any ready cash with me. I don't have any money in cash with me." So, Griffin had to admit that he had no ready cash. He pretended, however, that he was expecting a check to arrive at any moment. So, but what he said, "Don't worry about the money. I'm waiting for my check to arrive. As soon as the check will arrive, I will pay the rest of the money." That was not reality, actually. That was just an excuse made by him. From where do the check will come? Because he was a jobless vendor. Okay? And moreover, he is not indulging himself in any kind of work. But he was making an excuse. It means that he was very clever in nature also. And he's perfect in making excuses too. Shortly afterwards, a curious episode occurred. Very early in the morning, a clergyman and his wife were awakened by the noises in the study. Creeping downstairs, they heard the chink of money. Chink means the chinking sound. When you put the coin one by one, the sound produced. That is called chink of money being taken from the clergyman's desk. So now, after that, what has happened? One after another, now strange incidents started happening in Iping. Earlier, the people were afraid also, and moreover, they were talking about the strange appearance of Griffin, the scientist there. But now strange things also started happening there. So what has happened there? That the one most important episode of this story is that is of clergyman desk. Clergyman, the person who is associated with church, you know. So they were both clergyman and his wife, they were slept. But early in the morning, what they heard some strange noise, some strange noises. Naturally, the person will be awakened by that. They went into the study, and what they have found, it has been found there that they heard the chinking of the money. So what the next step? They will see who is stealing the money. How the money is being stolen. But now see, because he is an invisible man, because when he is doing these type of crimes, what he is doing, he is taking off his all clothes so that he won't be visible. And this is the strange thing that the people found there. So without making any noise and with the poker, poker is a long stick, grasped firmly in his hand, the clergyman flung open the door. Naturally, the person will think that a person is inside and we will calmly go inside in order to take hold of the person. So what they did, they took a poker, long stick, and with that, for example, poker, they have flung the door open so that no one would come to know. And ultimately, as they entered, they said, surrender. Whosoever it is, surrender. But who is there? No one is there, because man was there, but he was not at all visible to anybody. Then, to his amazement, he realized that the room appeared to be empty. But when they entered the room was empty. But who is there who is stealing the money? If no one is there, naturally, this incident would easily spread around the town that this happened with clergyman. He and his wife looked under the desk and behind the curtains and even up the chimney. There wasn't a sign of anybody. Yet the desk has been opened and the housekeeping money was missing. So now they thought no one is there. They would see behind the door, then behind the curtains. And finally, they thought maybe the man has escaped from the chimney. One has gone upstairs to check and one has seen from down that is there anybody? But no one was there. But when they have seen the drawer from where the money was kept, they have found that the housekeeping money was missing. It means the burglary has been done. It has been attempted, but who? No man was there. Some thought that it is a ghost. Then who is this? Extraordinary affair. The clergyman kept saying for the rest of the day. Now this is completely out of sense of clergyman. He is not able to figure it out. What has happened? Throughout the day to everyone, he is saying, this is really an extraordinary affair. Means extraordinary thing that I have witnessed. Throughout in my life, I have never seen this kind of thing. That when nobody is in the room, but the money is missing. How is this possible? But it was not an extraordinary as the behavior of Mrs. Hall's furniture a little later that morning. So next, another extraordinary thing happened. So what happened? Next is the behavior of the Mrs. Hall's furniture. See what has happened early in the morning. So the landlord and his wife were up very early and were surprised to see the scientist's door wide open. Next morning, what happened? So these kind of strange incidents happened. And this is the reason why he captured the attention of the police also, so that everyone was after him. You will notice further. So that morning, Mrs. Hall and Mr. Hall were awake early in the morning. And when they were awoke, they were having a round of their inn. And what did they see? They saw that the door of the room of the stranger was open. But otherwise, what is there? It is usually closed. Okay? It is usually closed. Okay? And he is not allowing anybody to enter his room also. So naturally, the curiosity of Mr. and Mrs. Hall, it aroused. They wanted to go inside. They wanted to see what strange he is doing. So usually it was shut and locked, and he was furious if anyone entered his room. So otherwise it is always locked. And if anyone enters his room, he is always furious. He's saying, don't come into my room. Please go out. I don't want to talk to anybody. He never liked anybody to enter his room. The opportunity seemed too good to be missed. So Mr. and Mrs. Hall, who was a little bit of inquisitive in nature, not Mr. Hall, she thought that this opportunity need not to be missed, so that we can have a look what is going on and what he is doing. They peeped round the door, saw nobody, and decided to investigate. So they peeped to have a look inside. They saw that nobody was there in the room. Finally, they thought, let us find what he is doing and what are the things that he has brought with him. The bedclothes were cold, showing that the scientist must have been up for some time. The stranger still, see, what is mentioned here, why it is mentioned and stranger still. And stranger still means that he is still a stranger there, because nobody knew anything about him. This is the reason. The clothes, the bandages that he always wore were lying about the room. So what did they find inside the room? They touched the bedclothes. They were cold, because if somebody would have sat over there or would have slept over there, they must have been warm. It was cold. They thought that nobody was there for some time. And then they have found that all the clothes that he was daily wearing and all the bandages, they were strewn around the room. Strewn means they were here and there in the room. Okay. And all of a sudden, Mrs. Hall heard a sniff close to her ear. Mrs. Hall was standing. Someone sniffed. Sniff means? Cheek man. Okay. Yes. She heard a sniff. Someone sneezing. Who was there? She was looking around, because nobody was there in the room from where this voice came. A moment later, the hat on the bedpost leapt up and dashed itself into her face. So suddenly what happened? The hat, which was placed on the bedpost, okay, at the back of the bed, it raised upward and it was dashed onto the face of Mrs. Hall. Uske muh pe aake bachti, without any man doing that. So then the bedroom chair became alive, springing into the air. It charged straight at her, legs foremost, and she and her husband, they were turned away in terror. The extraordinary chair pushed them both out of the room and then appeared to slam and lock the door after them. Then the chair, it became alive. Suddenly it seemed that the chair has some power. It was roused and it dashed back Mrs. Hall as well as Mr. and Mrs. Hall out of the room. And someone slammed the door from behind. Who's that? Invisible man it was. But the people did not know the reality that he was invisible. They thought that it to be some ghost. So, Mrs. Hall almost fell down the stairs in hysterics. Now, Mrs. Hall, who is not able to tolerate all this, you can say strange things happening. She is about to swoon. Behosh hone ki halat mein thi. She is going downstairs and she was holding her head. Oh no, what is this happening? What has happened to me? They thought that this is some kind of ghost there. She was convinced that the room was haunted by spirits. She definitely thought, no, this room is haunted by spirits. Haunted by spirits means that there is some ghost in the room. And that the stranger had somehow forced these to enter into her furniture. And they thought, it is only stranger who has allowed, he has done something that the ghost, they have entered into the furniture. They did not know that it was the stranger himself, who was an invisible man, who was doing all this. Because nobody has ever the idea that a man can be invisible. And that was the only rarest formula that Griffin has invented. So, my poor mother used to sit in that chair, she moaned, to think it should rise up against me now. So she was crying and saying, my poor mother used to sit in her chair, and now that chair is against me? How is this possible? She was never expecting it. So, the feeling among the neighbors was that the trouble was caused by witchcraft. So this word spread, this story spread around. So some people were giving their opinion, this is some witchcraft, koi bhoot preet hai, some ghosts. But witchcraft or not, when news of the burglary at the clergyman's home became known, the strange scientist was strongly suspected of having had a hand in it. So this story spread around the town, and moreover of that of the burglary that was held at clergyman's desk. So this story spread, but people did not know who has done it. But they definitely know this thing, that stranger has some hand in it, that the stranger must have been involved in all this. He must have been involved in it. Suspicion grew even stronger when he suddenly produced some ready cash though he had admitted not long before that he had no money. So all the suspicions, they grew strong. Why? Because the money had been stolen and already he had admitted that he had no money in cash. So everyone was thinking maybe he has done this kind of burglary in order to get money. So the village constable was secretly sent for. Instead of waiting for the constable, Mrs. Hall went to the scientist who had somehow mysteriously appeared from his empty bedroom. So now, because of all this, they have sent the constable, village constable to be called. He has arrived, Mrs. Hall, without waiting anymore. She went into the room of the scientist. And see, it was locked and from nowhere, scientist was inside the room. Again, strange thing happened. I want to know what you have been doing in my chair upstairs. She demanded. And I want to know how it is you came out of an empty room and now you have entered a locked room. She went inside with the constable and she said, I want to know that what you were doing with the chair and how you have entered in this room, locked room. Because earlier it was empty and how you have come. So see what was his answer. The scientist was always quick-tempered. Quick-tempered means he was short-tempered. Immediately he used to give reaction. What he said, he became furious again. You don't understand who or what I am? He shouted, very well, I'll show you. Kehta, tumhe pata nahi main kaun hu? You don't know who am I? If not, let me show you. Kehta, main tumhe dikhata hu main kaun. So what he did the next moment, suddenly he threw all off bandages, his whiskers, his spectacles and even his nose. He threw all his bandages, nose utar ke fenk deta, apni whiskers, hat utar ke fenk deta, and in front of Mrs. Hall, a man without hat. Again, very strange thing happened. How is this possible? So, this horrified people in the bar and found themselves staring at a headless man. And in the bar, all the people, they were surprised that in front of them, what is this? This is a headless man. How is this possible? Strange things again and again are going to happen. So, next, Mr. Jeffers, the constable, now arrived. So, by the time Mr. Jeffers, who is the village constable, he has also arrived there. And he was quite surprised to find that he had to arrest a man without a head. So people were telling to the constable, no, there is a man who is not having head. Mr. Jeffers, he was thinking how he would be able to catch a man without a head. How he has to catch a headless man. So in the next lecture, we will see that what he will do in order to catch him. Right? So this was really a very strange story. Okay, in which the people are after an invisible man. But they did not know they are after an invisible man. They thought that it is some kind of ghost or something else. So in the next lecture, we will continue following.